Welcome. This is a walkthrough of Sauce for Strava. Sauce is a browser extension that extends the Strava website with more in-depth analysis and in some cases fixes some bugs. Sauce currently requires Google Chrome or Chromium-based browsers. There's also plans for Firefox support in the future. And we're going to be talking about version 5 of Sauce, which is scheduled for release in February of 2020. So let's go. First, we're going to look at an activity with Sauce not enabled, and then we'll turn on the extension and reload the page. And this will show you the additional content. So we see a peak power table on the left, which is showing you the best 10-minute, 15-minute power, etc., inline comments, some additional overview stats, and you can also set and override the FTP and weight of the athlete. If we click on one of the rows in the peak power table, we'll see additional information about the effort, VAM, elevation, cadence, etc., heart rate, normalized power for longer efforts. We can change the category of the peak range table by clicking on it and see peak normalized power, peak heart rate, peak VAM. If we click on analysis view, then we'll see additional stats about the effort. If you want to access the raw data stream, you can have a look at it in a sort of a CSV table. And in fact, you can download it as a CSV file. If you change the selection, the stats are updated. And if the selection is long enough, then you'll see normalized power. If we click on the activity menu, you'll see two new options for exporting the activity. Now, if we take a look at a run, we have similar information. Instead of peak power, we have peak pace and peak gap, which is grade adjusted pace. If we click on analysis view, this will bring up the analysis page, which is ordinarily hidden for running activities, but Sauce exposes it. In addition to pace information, there's a power estimation, which is based on grade adjusted pace. There are some options for the dashboard or the activity feed. So if we load an activity feed, and then change one of the options like chronological feed. You can also choose to hide virtual activities from the feed. It will still show your own virtual activities. That about wraps it up. I tried to keep this video very brief. If you'd like a more detailed, in-depth video, let me know. And hopefully you enjoy Sauce.